You're desperate to create your own chatbots or AI assistants without coding at all? The genie of the AI lamps will fulfill your wish and show you how to do it with Flowise. Let's discover and play with Flowise. Just a reminder for the previous video, we are now in level 3 of abstraction, so we use a no or low code solution. Flowise is an open source project. It is distributed under an Apache 2 license, and it sits on top of LangChain.js and provides a UI to compose easily LangChain components and compose flows and interconnect them to create a more complex flows. So I will provide two examples of Flowise today. The first one is a very simple one. I just want to chat with OpenAI ChatGPT, and I will use Flowise from the official NPM repository. So I will connect to my Linux box and install Flowise from NPM and then just start it. All right. Then as soon as it is started, I will connect to the UI and start playing with my flow. So let's connect to the Linux box first. Then I already installed the NPM package. So now I just want to start Flowise with this command. Okay, now Flowise is started and it's listening on this port. So let's connect to the UI. There we go. Flowise UI now is up. All right, I already pre-configured my two examples. Here, the main component that you deal with within Flowise are chat flows, but you also have marketplace where you can share some templates. You also have the concept of tools assistants that are coming with some of the LLMs, for instance, OpenAI. It also deals with credentials, variables, and API keys. So let's go in our OpenAI chat. So when I am in a flow, then you see you have the components here and you can make some links between them. What is interesting here is on the side, you have the menu of all the components that you can add to a flow. And you see there are many, many of them. For instance, if you want to see what are the models that are supported by Flowise, basically they are the same as LangChain.js. So for instance, here you'll see you have the ones from Bedrock, you have a Cloud, you have a Vertex, you have Google, you have Hugging Faces or even local models, Mistral. You also have memories, so to keep memory of the conversation, so you can use the buffer memory. That's the object I decided to use for this very simple example. But we could decide to use more persistent memories, like store the history in MongoDB or other kind of database, for instance. You also have different kind of parsers, retrievers to deal with documents or to split them. And you have also the concept of vector store that we'll use in our second example. Here, in this very simple example, I decided to use the conversation chain, which is a pre-configured template that expect to be connected to a language model. So the language model is Chat OpenAI. I had already provided my key. I decided to use the GPT-4 model and I leave everything else by default. Okay, and I also connected to this chain a buffer, a simple buffer memory with the key by default that I left chat history. And the idea is to just have the memory, the history of the conversation we have with the LLM. As soon as I finished configuring my my flow here, directly from the UI, I can test with this icon my chatbot. So I can ask my question, for instance, why is the sky blue? And then directly I am discussing with OpenAI GPT. Right, so this is very useful, no need to code anything, and we already have a flow running. What is even more interesting is that in Flowise, you can also embed things very easily. So when I click here, I have a way to embed with this HTML instruction my chatbot in any web page just by copying and pasting this code. All right. So it will take some JS component from the internet, and with the proper parameters, I will be able to access. So let's test this out. For instance, let's say I want to inject it in this Jupyter Notebook page. So I copy this script here. I created a script element, and then I inject the HTML within the element. So let's run this code. And then you see behind me this icon. So when I click here, yes, I have access to Flowise. So I can discuss, you know, with the system. So very good. What we can do also, let me close this box. Okay, we can also customize this chat box. So when you're here and you check this box, then you have extra parameters that you can change, like colors, icons, default messages and things. And if it's not sufficient, you can even fork this over Flowise GitHub project, and then go even deeper in the way you customize the chat box. So this is it for our first example. It's very easy to declare declare some flows with the UI and then inject them in a web page, for instance. Now let's go with a more advanced example, and let's speak about RAG. So what I want to do now is I want to implement the RAG pattern. So what is the RAG? It's Retrieval Augmented Generation. The idea is to set up a contextual dataset with some information that can be injected at runtime based on the query of the user. Before sending the query to the LLM, we will ask our contextual dataset for the most relevant elements to inject them with the prompt, and so give the LLM the contextual element to make his answer based on what he already knows from his pre-training phase, but also with our contextual element. To do that, we need to call the embedding API from VertexAI, because I want to use now VertexAI, and before asking questions to users, so we create our own contextual dataset. So we'll use Chroma as a vector store. So Chroma is a specialized database. It's an open source project also. And in Chroma, we will store the contents, the equivalent in vectors of the content of my PDF file, okay? So first, let's install Chroma. We will run everything within Docker this time. So I will first install Chroma in a Docker, and then Flowise also. So on my Linux box, I just clone the Chroma repository, and then I will create the, I already built the Docker container. Now what I want to do is just to run it and to launch it. So let's connect to the Linux box again. I'm in my Chroma repository, and what I do now is I just want to launch the Docker stuff. All right. So here I didn't change the default parameters, and then I have my container called Chroma server that is running. Okay. Now I can test and check that everything is okay. For instance, I will connect to Chroma API. So here I have the Swagger UI. So Chroma is up and running. And for instance, if I want to see if I have collections, so collection is the equivalent of a schema or a database in Chroma, and I want to see if I already have connection or not. So let's try it out here. Execute, and then I have the answer. Here I have already a collection because I did a test before. Maybe I want to get rid of this my collection stuff. So let's use the API to do that. And go here, for instance, delete. I want to delete this collection. Okay, try it out. I want to delete my collection. compute. Right. Let's check again. Here, I have, so my Chroma database is now empty. All right. So, having Chroma up and running, now let's deal with Flowise itself. So this time I won't use the Node.js package, but I want to create a Docker one. What I'll do is, I did already on my Linux box also clone the repository. I did copy the default .env file, and I did change the content of the Docker Compose file also, because what I want this container to be in the same virtual network as Chroma, the one we created before. So let's check what's going on the Linux box. Okay, here. So if I go this time into my Flowise Docker subfolder, and then I run also the Docker Compose, then it will create the Docker container. Right. So everything is started. So I should be able again to connect to my UI. Where's my link? It's the same as the first example. Here. Right. So I go back to my example here. Flowise container. And we'll speak about the right flow. So here we are. So again, I have the same UI, and because the data are the same, it's on my on the hard drive of my Linux box. I have this chat flow, but I also have the one I want to expose right now. Okay, so the right flow, just to give some more details, what we'll need to do is first to open the PDF file, cut it in chunks. Ask the embedding model for the equivalent embedding vectors, store them into the Chroma vector store that we just created. All right. And then when the user is asking a question, we'll also convert the question in a vector, make a search on the vector store, get the most relevant vectors, and then inject them in the prompt, send everything to LLM, and then display the answer to the user. So it's a lot of steps. It's a kind of workflow. And what is powerful with LangChain and with Flowise is we can use some predefined workflows called chain or flows in Flowise. All right. So let's go on the Flowise UI, and this time with the VertexAI RAG flow. Here you see it's a little bit more complex, but basically here I use the conversational retrieval Q&A chain this time. And what is different is there is a vector store retriever added here. So we still have a chat model. This time we use Google Vertex AI. I want to use the chat bison model. Okay. I also have the buffer memory, just like in the first example, but this time I also connect the vector store. So it is Chroma. This is, I wanted to call it my collection. This is the URL that we have to use, because you are within a virtual network, so the two Docker container, Chroma and Flowise, are communicating with this address. And then here I want this document, which is a PDF document created from a PowerPoint presentation. I want one document per page to be created here. And then I want Flowise and LangChain underneath to use the embedding model of Vertex AI to create the vectors and store them into Chroma. Okay, so what I can do from here first is to insert the content and populate my Chroma database. So I click on this icon and I want to insert everything. Okay, so my database is populated right now. Now, what I want to do is just like in the first example, ask my question. This time, I will ask a very specific question. What is the text quad? And wait for the answer to come. here we are. The tech squad is a group of 50 people, blah, blah, blah. So you see, it's a very contextualized and it's based on the content of my initial PDF file. What is interesting also, because I did check this this radio button to say, okay, return also the sources that you use to make your answer. So basically, that are these are the four vectors that were embedded in my final communication with the text completion of Vertex AI. So if I click on this one, I see that this is this content that was used. Okay, so it's very nice, and we see that without making any coding, we are able to implement quite easily the rack pattern. All right. If I go back to my Jupyter notebook here, one final test that we can do is first maybe using the same Swagger API. This time I want to execute the same one, and we see now we recreated my collection schema within Chroma, and maybe we could also let me copy this ID, the ID of the of this collection, and we will ask how many vectors we have in our database, for instance. So that will be collection, let me see, collection count, yeah, maybe this one. So I want to count. This is the ID, execute. There we are. We have 26 vectors in our Chroma. So the PDF file was translated in 26 vectors. And basically, that's the number of slides of my original PowerPoint file. Okay. But the last thing I want to show you is this time, I want to access to the flow, to the API exposed by Flowise. But this time not with an embedding embedded HTML, but with the JavaScript code. So you see, I just have to copy that and run it from my Node.js code. I also have the code for Python available. So if I go back to my Jupyter notebook, I just copy here the code, and here's my question again. So basically, what you see, I'm doing an asynchronous call to the API of Flowise. And I give my my question. I pass the parameters here. All right, so let's execute this code now and wait for the answer. Here we go. So now the text word is a group, blah, 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 blah. All right, so that's it. That was a quite a quick tutorial, but it's just to illustrate the power of Flowise and of blockchain. It's leveraging the power of this framework, but we do sit on this level of abstraction. Longchain is right underneath, okay? And it's quite easy to make some flows. I just gave you two simple examples, but obviously you can create your own flows within the Flowise UI and make your business case or your use case very easily, at least for prototyping things. All right, I hope this very quick tutorial gave you some insight on Flowise, and you're motivated to go and try it. And that's it for now. Keep making wishes, and maybe the GenAI's lamp will fulfill them. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.